Randomized experiments are designed and implemented by the researchers from the very beginning. Now, there are going to be two similar situations that we're going to look at next. The first is called a true natural experiment. This is where treatments are actually randomly assigned. And the second is called an as-if natural experiment. And this is where treatments are assigned by a procedure which is arguably random for all practical purposes. Now, both of these cases are going to use observational data. So we get treatment assignment by some process out there in the world, and we as the researchers come across it after the fact, after the data has already been generated. So that's going to be the main difference between natural experiments and randomized experiments, is that a natural experiment is going to use observational data, but the analysis will look very similar to the analysis of randomized experiments. So let's talk about true natural experiments. These are the most like an actual randomized experiment because we know that the treatment was randomly assigned. And the only difference here is that it was randomly assigned by somebody other than the researcher. So usually in real life, this happens because there wasn't enough money to treat everyone. So they hold a lottery to decide who gets treated. So a very common example of this is analyzing the effects of charter schools. So charter schools are public schools that have more flexibility and autonomy than traditional public schools. So they typically draw students from the entire district instead of a specific area. They often have many more students who apply for entering into the charter school than they have capacity for. And so what they do is they randomly pick who gets in. So here, for example, I have a picture of a public lottery ceremony held at the Harlem Success Academy in New York City. So what many of these schools do is they actually hold lotteries in public where they pick the students' names from this pot of who's going to get in, and all the parents show up to see if their kids got into school. And there's actually a documentary made about this in charter schools called The Lottery. Okay, so in some cases, we're going to see data like some students get randomly chosen to be in the charter school, some students get randomly assigned not to be in the charter school, and that's a natural experiment. We're going to be able to use that data to analyze the effect of being in a charter school on outcomes like how much you make, et cetera, et cetera. An as-if natural experiment is where the treatment was not literally randomly assigned, like it was, for example, with the charter school lottery, but the researcher can convincingly argue, or they attempt to argue at least, that it was as if treatment was randomly assigned. And what that means is that the treatment assignment is not related to any variable that might affect the outcomes, okay? So for example, you may have some social program that is implemented by the government, and the way it's implemented is it's slowly rolled out across different localities in a very non-systematic way. So they don't go from north to south or south to north or whatever, or they don't decide really that this county is going to be the one to get the program first, and then this one gets it first because this one's better in some way or another. They just, for whatever bureaucratic reason, decide that some region gets the program first and some regions don't. So the idea is that eventually all the regions are going to be treated, they're all going to get the program, but the regions that get treated first are essentially chosen at random. And this is called an as-if natural experiment.